You're watching Nonprofit Spotlight, and we're at Habitat for Humanity, South Santa Barbara County. We'll be talking with Executive Director Joyce McCullough and Finance Director John Peterson. Let's start our spotlight. Thank you, Joyce, for being with us today. Can you start off by telling us what the mission is of Habitat for Humanity, South Santa Barbara County?
Right. Thanks, Megan, for allowing us to come and participate in this. And Habitat for Humanity is a nonprofit ecumenical Christian ministry devoted to eliminating substandard housing. We provide one of the rare opportunities for home ownership for families around the world, but our particular focus is in the Southern Santa Barbara County area.
I'm sure many of our viewers have heard about Habitat for Humanity. How long have you been here in South Santa Barbara County?
You know, it's really a grassroots movement, and we had a number of volunteers that formed our organization in 2000,
okay.
And they immediately started doing some rehab projects while they were looking for the first construction project. They hired me in 2003, and we then were able to really get going on our first construction project, which was three homes that were completed in 2007. The families have been living there now for 3 years.
Wow.
So it's a wonderful project because the families are really transformed. You know, home ownership confers such stability and long-term transformation for the families. We're very pleased to see that happen in the families' lives whom we serve.
I'm sure those stories are amazing. What great successes. Talking more about affordable housing, can you explain to me the need of affordable housing in Santa Barbara?
You know, I think sometimes poverty is kind of hidden in this very beautiful, very affluent community in which we live. But there are pockets of poverty, and we find people who are not otherwise served by some of the very good housing agencies that we have in town. We find people living doubled up in apartments intended for single people or certainly single families. We see families that are living in unconverted garages with no plumbing and no wiring except for a bare light bulb over their heads. And we just want to see that not be something that marks Santa Barbara. We want to provide opportunities for all families in our community to have a decent place to live.
You mentioned some of your past projects. What projects are you working on right now?
We're very lucky. We have a number of volunteers and contractors who have donated their time. Behind me is our current project, which is four homes over on San Pasqual. We hope to have those complete very soon. And those four families are working their sweat equity hours. So we're very excited by the progress. And it's just been such a joy to be out at the site with the volunteers who are giving their time to Habitat.
And speaking of volunteers, how can our viewers, people in the community, get involved with Habitat for Humanity?
That's one of the hallmarks of who we are. We sort of go back to the old ethos of the community barn raising. So we love volunteers, and we try and make that easy for them by allowing them to register on our website, www.sbhabitat.org. We have volunteer days Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And we have all skill levels that come out. If all you want to do is come out and push a broom, we need that. We love it. If you're a licensed contractor or a skilled person, a handy homeowner, any level of skill, we will welcome you. We provide crew leaders at the site who will direct and guide your activities for the day and make sure that things are built according to code.
That always an important thing.
Very important, yes. We want to build a quality project.
And in addition to volunteering, what other ways can people contribute to Habitat for Humanity?
Well, you know, our website is also a great resource for events that we have over and over again. We have probably three or four events at least during the year that are educational as well as an effort to raise funds for Habitat. So again, go to our website and see what current events are happening. And then also, of course, we need financial support as well. So we're always looking for people who are willing to donate a little or a lot. We work with a lot of government funding and grant money, but the biggest portion of our funding comes from individuals who support our work.
Well, you hear that, everyone. Habitat for Humanity is definitely in need of volunteers and any financial contributions. Joyce, thank you so much for talking with us today. And next up, we'll have John, who is the finance director here at Habitat for Humanity. But I wanted to just say thanks again for taking the time.
Well, thank you so much. This is a wonderful opportunity. Thanks, Megan.
Thank you. Thank you, John, for joining us today. Can you start out by telling us who Habitat for Humanity of South Santa Barbara County serves?
Yeah, definitely. We serve low to very low income families, so working families that are making between 40 to 60% of the area median income. And so roughly for a family of four, that's right around $40,000 for an annual salary of their combined incomes. So it's a smaller group, but it's a group that's working, and that's a really important part of our community here in Santa Barbara.
Exactly. And how are those families selected?
It's a pretty lengthy process, but we go through an application process where we have an orientation session to kind of give people the information they need. And then we have a committee that reviews the applications and then selects the families based on three main qualifications. They have an ability to pay, and they're paying on a 0% mortgage. It's a no interest and no profit mortgage, so it's affordable. They need to have a willingness to partner. Each of the adults in the family put in 250 hours of sweat equity. So a lot of that's done working on their own house, spend a lot of time there. And then finally, that they have a need for affordable housing. So they have to currently be living in an area that, in a housing situation that's substandard or overcrowded. There's lots of programs in Santa Barbara for quality rental homes, and those are not necessarily the families we're looking to serve, but families that have not been able to be a part of that.
In addition to providing affordable housing to families that need it, what other ways does Habitat for Humanity serve the local community?
Yeah, I would say that we have two significant things. One is up and running and has been for a couple of years now, and that's our Habitat for Humanity Restore. Mm-hmm. And that's located in Goleta at 6725 Hollister Avenue in Goleta. And what it is, it's a store, a resale store, where we take lightly used home building supplies,
okay,
doors, windows, bathroom fixtures, light fixtures, that kind of thing, tile. And then we resell them to anybody in the community for 50 to 80% of the retail price.
Wow.
So significantly reduced prices. And the Restore is open to everybody and anyone. We're open Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from noon to 5.
Okay.
And Saturdays from 9 to 5.
Fantastic.
And then the second thing that we're doing is a new program that we're starting, and we're calling it A Brush with Kindness. And basically what it is, it's a simplified version of our regular home building. And so this is still for families making 40 to 60% of area median income, but they are already homeowners. And what we do is we go in and we do some exterior painting, some landscaping, updating or repair, and some minor fence repair. So it's a new program we're doing to try and serve more families and get involved in more of the community here in Santa Barbara.
Interesting. And people can find out more about each of those programs at your website.
Absolutely. Yep. They can go to www.sbhabitat.org and find out about both of those.
Well, thank you again, John, for joining us today. We continue to look forward to hearing all of the wonderful things that Habitat for Humanity is doing in our community.
Well, thanks very much. It's been a pleasure having you.
Fantastic. You're watching Nonprofit Spotlight.
If you'd like your nonprofit featured in a future Nonprofit Spotlight, contact us at the information on your screen.